When I felt a lump on my breast, I actually did not know what kind of a doctor to go to also. You know, I actually Googled who to go to if you have a breast lump. So that was the level of me being unaware of, you know, what if something like this happens, or what if you find a change in your body. I know of a lot of women who have continued work, you know, even while the treatment was on. And what most of these women have done is that they kind of plan their chemotherapy in a way that they have a sitting on Friday, you know. So Friday they took, you know, they take a leave, and then Saturday, Sunday is mostly off. So by the time Monday comes, you know, they have gathered the energy again to go back to work for those next 4 to 5 days. So I have seen a lot of women, you know, continue to work while they were on with their treatment in this way. I have also seen a lot of companies being very supportive, you know, so they would allow some of them to work from home if they are, you know, if they were not feeling fine. The co-workers also to be very supportive. But again, I've seen a mix in this also, because I've also seen a lot of people, you know, telling me that, you know, that I want to give a job interview, or, you know, the people in my company would get to know that I have cancer, you know, since my hair are falling. I don't want people to know about it, you know, because then there are too many gossips going around. You know, there are times when people are not that supportive. There are times, you know, when people come and probe about, did you have to lose a breast to it? So not everybody is as open to discuss it, you know, while they are undergoing the treatment.